Unlike recessive trait pedigrees, dominant traits appear more frequently within a pedigree and often do not skip generations. I'm showing you here a really great example of a dominant trait called achondroplasia. Achondroplasia is a major cause of dwarfism in humans. Now, in this particular pedigree, again, you'll notice right away that it affects every generation, right? We see every generation from grandparents to parents to children, we see affected individuals. Now, up to this point in the course, we haven't talked about any specific genetic alleles that cause achondroplasia. But no worry, we can go back to using our symbols like we were using for lactose intolerance, the plus and the minus. In this case, the plus, or the dominant allele, is actually for achondroplasia, which causes dwarfism. And the minus allele is what we're going to call quote-unquote normal. In this case, what we mean by normal is just normal height. So take a look at this particular grandfather in this pedigree of the dominant trait achondroplasia, and I want you to tell me, what are the possible genotypes of this indicated grandfather? This question is not as simple as it seems. So take a nice hard look at the pedigree here, and then give it your best shot. Check any and all boxes that you think apply.